Welcome to the 2011 Mind to Market Award. Our four finalists this year are Arian Labs, Bombardier Transportation, Chide.it, and Plantform Corporation. And each one is a real life example of what can be achieved when you connect Ontario's world-class academic researchers with promising companies from across the province. Choosing a winner wasn't easy. Our panel, made up of leading minds from across Ontario, judged this year's nominees on four criteria: innovation, collaboration, commercialization, and the wow factor.
I'm always impressed and totally thrilled with the energy and enthusiasm of the young innovators and their partners, and seeing the amazing collaborations that exist out there.
It was really close. All four candidates were absolutely excellent.
Here are your 2011 Mind to Market Award finalists.
Arian Labs designed small, man-packable robots designed for the back pocket of every soldier and the trunk of every police car. Arian's key technology is the Arian Scout. It's a small helicopter, weighs about 3 pounds, assembled in under 1 minute. And the real differentiating part about our product is that you control it with a map. You can simply touch on a map where you want it to go and it flies itself.
They built a very technologically challenging product and built it in such a way that anybody could use it. From Libya and Colombia and drug busts to helping the troops out in Afghanistan.
So the use of the Arian Scout by the Libyan rebels was a big proof point for us. What the technology was able to do was give the rebels the ability to get aerial support where they didn't have this before. They can't afford large manned helicopters and the personnel to pilot them, whereas this system they were able to learn in a matter of days and bring information back from the front lines, keeping them safe.
Arian has already created 30 jobs. Their growth area expects them to take on 20 more jobs in the next year. They've moved into new premises. I would expect Arian in 5 or 6 years' time to have 200 plus employees.
Particularly working with Mike Peasgood and Dave Crouch, they have an excellent handle on what the customers need, on what the product limitations are, and how we can push those forward. And so things that we're working on in the lab are now more likely to have an impact, or more likely to make it to market because of this wonderful collaboration that I have with Arian.
I think 2011 has been a fantastic breakout year for us. What's really happened is the proof that our product is real world and ready for success.
Chide.it has two products. There's Fluid Surveys and there's Review Room. Both are really exciting. Both are software as a service products and both are doing really, really well. So with Fluid Surveys, anyone can get online with a super easy to use drag and drop interface, build a survey and form, for the purpose of collecting valuable data to help them make business critical decisions.
We now have 19 people that we hired over the past year. The people that we are hiring are all knowledge-based jobs. So we are really creating a high value job, not only the job itself. So there's two parts to it.
I think this company is going places because this is the first time I've worked with a company that grew from 2 people to 20 people.
I see Chide.it as a $10 million, 50-person company in 3 to 5 years. I see them as leading in the space in Canada. I see them as leading internationally as well. And I see that they're going to be really, really successful. And I think that Ottawa is going to wake up one day and say, where did this company come from?
We're very excited about Plantform. It's a company that was spun out of the University of Guelph, and we use tobacco plants to make therapeutic drugs to cure cancer. The first product is a biosimilar or generic version of the drug Herceptin. This is a $6 billion market product in the healthcare area. Our version of Herceptin is going to be produced using tobacco, which is going to make it the cheapest version of a drug in the market. We produce the drugs at 10% of the cost of a traditional manufacturing method.
We're moving ahead at the research level ahead of the company, but the company primarily is focused on the technology we've already brought to the table, implementing it and getting the drug out inexpensively and in a timely manner.
It's going to create jobs in Ontario. We don't have a lot of basic pharmaceutical manufacturing, we have a lot of clone type manufacturing, and this is the opportunity to actually create an industry which is going to hire people to actually work in controlled greenhouse environments to collect the material to make the drug.
TrackSafe is unique in the marketplace. We have focused on delivering a complete user experience. The product is intuitive and easy to use and provides alerts to enable safer transit operations.
All the railway tracks, they need to be inspected regularly. Bombardier wanted to find a solution to make the work of the track worker safer. And we chose radio frequency identification tag. The track worker, they will wear a wrist watch, and when they enter the tunnel, they will scan, which will read the identification of the track worker that are entering the track. There is a bubble around the track worker, which now is sort of known they are in that space.
Initially, Bombardier and McMaster approached us with the project, and what was kind of unique about it is that they, particularly Bombardier, had clearly put a lot of thought into the problem and the opportunity that was around coming up with a solution for it. I think the other thing that you have to understand with large companies is that they're not necessarily engaged with the academic community here. And building those engagements can really help them with their business case for why they want to continue to do business from Ontario.